Hello, hello, viewers. We are at our mobile studio, AVIT channel, at Pro AV Competence Days in Krakow 2025. And my guest this time is...
Katrin Kerber from Matrox Video, and I'm happy to be here for the first time.
What's happened that you are here for the first time?
Nothing said and nothing to be sorry about. My colleague Jörg usually was responsible for Poland, and he decided to move on in a new area of work within Matrox still. And actually he's still here. He helped yesterday with the stage upstairs, the nice artistic video wall. He did this. This is a tradition, obviously. But I'm happy because I got assigned to the Polish market on July 1st. So I'm happy to come back, to meet you more often, to also continue the good work that Jörg has started with you and give a female smile to it. All right?
Okay. And I hope next time we'll see again also in other circumstances, in other places, like ISE, perhaps.
Definitely. We will be pleased to welcome you at ISE, because that's always the place where Matrox is presenting new products. And we have something interesting coming, actually, something big coming, the secret sauce, as we call it in Matrox. So I'm happy to invite you already now.
Sounds good. So probably will be. I want to ask you one question, technical question, about Matrox Video. How open standards help building scalable and most flexible modern AV over IP based ecosystems at Matrox Video?
Well, the first thing is to speak about standards. Standards help people to orient on something that is common for no matter which brand you're using. I like to say EDID, for example, for displays, as Sharp NEC, of course, as a display manufacturer, also supports the standard. But for the customer, the nice thing is, no matter if he uses Sharp, Philips, or Samsung, the mechanism how the graphic card talks to the display is the same. So with IPMX and SMPTE 2110 as open standards for media transport in networks, we are trying to do the same thing. So no matter if you use Matrox sender and receiver, or if you use a Matrox sender and a Nova Star LED controller, we can talk to each other because we kind of use the same language to communicate. And this is enabling customers now to build nice interoperable workflows, to choose the brands they like to choose for its purpose. But it's also the thing that open standards like SMPTE 2110 and IPMX allow you to choose if you do compressed or uncompressed. And particularly in compressed workflows, you can be very scalable to a large amount of endpoints without having problems with the network. As codec becomes now an option, you are also free to choose the network switches and the network infrastructure that you feel relevant for your project. So this flexibility makes you very cost efficient, and open standards will help actually to facilitate a lot of AV over IP workflows now and in the future.
Thank you for your explanation. Very technical, not easy, but very clear.
Thank you very much.
But could you give me an example of scalable installation with those which you mentioned before? Example which could explain how does it work?
Well, scalable can be seen in a way of adding network or adding different bit rates to the same network. Yeah. So for example, if we speak about theater workflows, you are familiar with the orchestra pit. Yeah, where people typically like to use AV distribution to show the musician in the last row the picture in very low latency. So here they would prefer to do uncompressed media transport.
During a concert.
During a concert or in a performance, yeah. But then you also have the AV distribution to the front of the house, to the wardrobes, behind the curtains, to actually inform every technician that works with the stage. And here you would prefer compressed workflow with copper cable, which is a little bit more solid. And open standards, and particularly Matrox Convert IP built on these standards, allows you with the same hardware to actually cover both workflows. Yeah, and the experience that we see as another example, we have Finlandia Talo, which is a landmark in Helsinki. Yeah, here it's also the starting part that they started to build the convention center built on IPMX, but the huge house in the center of Helsinki has also concert hall, it has auditoriums and theaters, and they can now in phases just develop and extend with open standards according to the needs of these specific areas in this convention center. And that is what we mean with scalable and flexibility. It's no longer locking you to this one or to this one, not to mention brands.
For whom? For which exactly customers here in Poland do you offer your open standards?
Yeah. First, I'm happy to say that I work with Consput Audio as our distributor and Modulit, that have also a specialization in audio over IP workflows, for example. And we are addressing Polish theaters, a musical academy. There's just recently a commissioning happening in one of the largest academies in Poland, which I'm not sure if I can talk already about it. Yeah, but we are seeing, I think we are working on 3 theaters at the moment in Poland, which is just the beginning. Yeah, with Modulit, we are working on a hospital installation, for example, some more classical AV over IP distribution in meeting rooms and so on. So yeah, it's starting, and I'm happy to continue developing the market for Matrox with the products we have. Yeah.
It looks very professional customers.
They are, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for this little interview for the first time.
Yeah.
And thank you to you. And my guest was Katrin.
Dziękuję. I hope I spelled it properly.
Very properly. Proszę bardzo.